Hello you guys, welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Susanna and I'm so excited to have you here with me today. I have a really fun and almost motivating video for you today. I'm going to be sharing my secrets, my top secrets when it comes to health, energy, feeling good, and productivity. I said that really weird. Productivity. Anyway, I'm going to be sharing my top tips for those things. Just kind of a broad spectrum of habits that I have implemented into my life that has made it significantly better. So I want to share that with you guys today. I'll go ahead and keep this intro pretty short so I can jump on into that. So without further ado, let's get started with tip number one. Okay, you guys. So tip number one is find a workout that you enjoy. So this at first may seem a little obvious, but let me explain. Okay, you guys, so something that you do not know about me is that I'm an aerialist. So I do aerial silks and I do pole, which are both really incredibly amazing workouts, super hard, but I also absolutely love them. It's so much fun. And also I'm learning a skill, which makes me feel like I'm accomplishing even more than improving my body health as a whole, which is an awesome goal to achieve. But now I feel like I am accomplishing a new skill. So it's like killing two birds with one stone. So I will be honest with you guys, I really hate the gym. And so 3 years back, I found aerial silks and pole and just fell in love with the sport. And it is so much fun. And honestly, it is one of the hardest workouts that I have ever done in my life. And I don't think I've ever been as fit as I am now. And also I'm, you know, kind of motivated to go because it's exciting and it's fun for me and I have goals in it. I would love to be an aerial silks instructor one day. So I think that it is very important to find something almost besides the gym that you just enjoy doing and that you actually are motivated to keep going, especially if there's kind of like a tight-knit community where you are constantly encouraging each other to go. That is very important. That is what I've been experiencing. And so if I miss a class, they're like, hey girl, where are you at? So when it comes to working out, if you need a tip on staying motivated, find something that you enjoy, whether it's rock climbing or playing frisbee outside, just something that's different than just going to the gym. Okay, so this tip kind of ties into tip number one, but my tip number two is stretching. And I'm not going to tell you just to do the normal stretching that everyone recommends. Oh, stretch and you'll feel better. Obviously that is true. And I do stretch every single day, mainly because I'm wanting to get more flexible, but also because it does feel really good and it makes my body feel better. But this is something that I had never heard of until I started silks and pole. And this thing is life-changing, you guys. I'm so serious about it. It is a peanut, and no, not the kind of peanut that you eat. It is this guy. This peanut is amazing. It hurts when you first start to use it, but it really, if you have a bad back, a back that hurts all the time, maybe you have a desk job and are constantly leaning over, this thing can be a game changer. And so what you do is you take the peanut and you put it to where one of the balls is on either side or both sides of your spine, and then you can lay down on it and kind of roll around or just put pressure on certain points, and it really feels so amazing. Okay, you guys, so tip number three is juicing. So juicing can honestly be a little bit more difficult to get into just because juicers, I know, can be a little bit expensive, but it is definitely worth the investment. I know people who have literally gotten rid of cancer through juicing. I'm not trying to give medical advice here. That is not what I'm doing. Disclosure there. But I know the powers of food and how good food can positively impact your body. And so constantly putting those vitamins in is so good. Again, not a doctor, but juicing can be very powerful. So what I notice in myself is juicing has really helped my skin. It's helped my energy levels. And it's also, I just feel like it's helped my overall health. And so here's what I have been juicing lately, my recipe. I've been doing celery, carrots, spinach, each either an apple or an orange, and then half of a lemon. And the lemon is really good for detoxing. Obviously, the vegetables are amazing for you just because of the vitamins. And then either the apple or the orange is good for flavor. I usually like to pick one or the other just to limit my sugar, but both have amazing benefits. I've heard that apple is really good for your skin. Don't take my word for that, but I really do like juicing green apples. Okay, so my next two tips are big for having energy throughout the day. So the very first thing that I do when I wake up in the morning is I drink 2 entire cups of water. Water really can help energize you. If you are feeling sluggish in the morning, ask yourself if you've had enough water today. Coffee's great, but then you crash. I do drink coffee. I am a coffee lover, but I usually drink 2 glasses of water and then just 1 cup of coffee. And let me tell you, it will help with energy levels. At least it has for me. Okay, so this is honestly a big one. So morning walks, or just honestly, just not laying around in the morning. I'm totally guilty of this during the weekends because, like, you know, who doesn't love a lazy Saturday morning? I definitely do. But usually I am a little bit more sluggish throughout the day. But I can usually tell a really big difference during the weekdays because as soon as I get up, I'll have a cup of coffee. I'll take like 10 minutes to wake up and then I will grab honey and we will go on a walk. And it really just helps your energy levels. I don't know what it is, but just to not lay around all morning, to get yourself up, get yourself moving, it just helps. I feel so much more sluggish if I lay around for an hour or two in the morning and I don't get my body moving. So again, great workout, right? There, that's another added workout within my week that I am getting some cardio right there, but then I am also providing myself more energy throughout the day. Okay, so my next tip is kind of an obvious one, but I want to go in a little bit more depth with it. So planners, as far as keeping yourself productive. And I have multiple, like, not planners, but multiple pads and planners and stuff that I use, and I'll kind of talk about those. For one thing, I do use an Erin Condren planner, and I absolutely love my Erin Condren planner because, number one, I get to decorate it and make it all cute. And they have so many fun accessories, so that's always a plus. But number two, there are just so many different sections for different things. You can keep it very organized and personalize it to how you like. But what I also have is I keep a weekly kind of notepad out that I can really plan my week. And I could do this in my Erin Condren planner, but I like to have it out where I can see it on the table. And so it has like a section for Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. So I literally like plan out my schedule, like 7:15, wake up, 7:30, go on walk, that kind of thing. And then I plan my entire morning, afternoon, evening, just that week. And then I tear that out and I plan my new week because my weeks kind of change week to week. And then what I have is I have a separate notebook that I use for to-do lists and shopping lists. Because things that you need to go out and buy when you run out can be really hard to keep up with in your head because they just get lost in there with all the other things that you have to get done and purchase and whatever. So I keep a notebook and I have a page that is for to-dos for the week and then a page for that is for shopping list for the week. And so like right now I have trash bags and paper towels and stuff like that on my shopping list, and then I have simple things on my to-do list that I need to get done, and that's just a little notebook that I keep with me, and that helps keep me accountable as far as my to-do list and helps remind me as far as my shopping list. Okay, you guys, so my very last tip is also kind of obvious, but I feel like sometimes people just don't take it for what it is, and this has always been one of my biggest tips, but just keep your place, keep your atmosphere that you're living in clean and organized. It will bring you just that mental peace to be able to get things done, especially since we are at home so much more now than we are used to being. It is just so important to keep your atmosphere clean and happy and organized, and it just, I promise you guys, it will give you just that extra little tinge of peace of mind and feeling more organized, and it will help your productivity. Okay, you guys, so those are all of my tips for today. I hope that you enjoyed them. I hope that you found them helpful. If you did, make sure you subscribe and hit that thumbs up. It would mean the absolute whole world to me. I upload new videos every Tuesday and Friday, so be sure to stay tuned for those. Bye, you guys.